Good afternoon. Welcome to St. Michael's. Just a few announcements before we begin Mass today. Please remember in your prayers the following special intentions: the repose of the souls of our recently deceased, including Greg Strapoli, Dr. Peter Ganley, Dr. Francisco D.V. Del Valle, Father Daniel Gowan, Lawrence T. Fell, Michael Chaffee, Barbara Popla, Robert Scally, and our brothers and sisters in Ukraine and the Holy Land. And also, please keep in your prayers the members of our parish and others who are in poor health or otherwise in special need of our fervent prayers, especially Dorothy, Kathleen, Patrick, Bob, Ellen, Richard, Cassandra, Florence, Marina, Annette, and those in need on the island of Maui. Please keep in mind the applicable COVID-19 health and safety protocols. Receiving communion on the hand is strongly encouraged, but not absolutely required. This weekend, we celebrate Divine Mercy Sunday, and the season of Easter continues. Extra hours for the Sacrament of Confession Sunday afternoon are noted in today's bulletin on page 3 and on the parish website. The Divine Mercy Chaplet will be prayed Sunday afternoon at 3 p.m. All are warmly invited and strongly encouraged to attend and participate in this grace-filled and grace-giving devotion. The 2024 Annual Catholic Appeal is underway. Our parish goal this year is $104,000 to support our diocese financially with its services, ministries, charities, and other expenses. The appeal is off to a good start here at St. Michael's. Details are in the bulletin. We have caught up to last year's pace, and we are only slightly behind 2022's pace as of the sixth weekend of the campaign. Annual appeal pledge cards, checks, and cash may be placed in today's second collection basket or mailed to or dropped off at the parish office. Please remember that a successful appeal campaign and the parish's hoped-for earning of an appeal rebate in excess of $15,000 are important components in our financial plan to replace the church's heating equipment and air conditioning equipment later this year. Thank you for your support of the annual Catholic Appeal. Please take home and read a copy of the parish bulletin for all other news and information. Thank you.
Welcome to St. Michael's Vigil Mass, celebrating the second Sunday of Easter, Divine Mercy Sunday. Please rise and join in our entrance song, number 229, All You on Earth, 229.
Rejoice and sing, give glory to our risen King. Raise your voices, alleluia. Our Lord who died now truly lives. To us this promise he now gives. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. In order for us better to celebrate Mass together this afternoon, let us first call to mind our Father's love and infinite mercy. And to show both so beautifully, he sent his Son. Lord, have mercy. His Son came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. His Son pleads for us at the Father's right hand. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and keep us in everlasting life.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We keep Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast rekindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font we have been washed, by whose spirit we have been reborn, and whose blood we are redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his mercy endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. I was hard-pressed and was failing, but the Lord helped me. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. The shoutful joy of victory in the tents of the just. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love is everlasting.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome, for whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world, but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of the first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord, and Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed upon them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain, they are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark and of the nails in his hand, and put my finger into his nail into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was this time with them. And Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst, and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side. And do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book, but these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord. Good afternoon, and good afternoon to each one of you in this magnificent church, and to those of you who are coming via the internet to join us in prayer. Know the Welsh worshiping community of St. Michael's welcomes you with great love. Fifty years ago, there was a group of dancers that assembled in an apartment down in Greenwich Village late at night after work. Some of them were dancing in shows, some of them were waiting on tables. And at night they all got together and they started to share with each other what it was that they went through in their childhood, little snippets. And all of a sudden this group said, you know, this is good stuff. And later on, they started to record their conversations. In the course of those conversations, one of the young women that was in the group was a Puerto Rican. And she brought on to say that she was accepted at the School of Performing Arts in New York City. Now, in 1960s, 1970s, that's a big deal for a little Puerto Rican girl from the Bronx. And she boasted about this great opportunity that she was given. And she went into the acting class on the first day. And the acting teacher was teaching some method acting. And he said, and she went on to say, the first time I was in the class, he wanted me to act like an ice cream cone. Now, how do you act like an ice cream cone? And she went on and she talked about it. And then the next day, in the same class, he said, now you're going to become a bobsled. How do you become a bobsled? But it was all talk. And all these little method acting things. And she confessed to the whole group, she says, you know what? I felt nothing. That song has been going through my mind a great deal for whatever reason these past couple of weeks, maybe because it's April and it's 50 years ago that happened. That show, by the way, went into workshop 6 months later. Down at the New York Shakespeare Festival, and then eventually moved to Broadway. It became Chorus Line that ran 15 years. She felt nothing, and she felt bad about it. This past Wednesday, Father John assigned me the 8 o'clock Mass. So I came here, I get up very early in the morning. I'm still on Air Force time, unfortunately. And I get up very early in the morning and I had coffee and all this business and got myself prepared for the day, came here. I said the 7 o'clock Mass, then I went and heard confessions in the back, came back, took the vestments off, and then I got in the car and drove to St. Wegmans and did my devotions over there. And I had nothing in the house, so I ended up with two bags of stuff, and I went home, put everything away. After I put everything away, there was half a cup of coffee left in the coffee pot on the counter. So I poured it, I put some milk in it, I put it in the microwave, I took it out, and I was standing by the sink looking out the window. I took one gulp of the coffee, and all of a sudden, the whole house shook. I said, that's one heck of a cup of coffee. Obviously, the earthquake hit at 10:23. I felt it. Did I see it? No. It happened about 40 miles northwest of here. And it happened 3 miles down. Now, how deep is that hole of 3 miles? The foundation of the Statue of Liberty is only 55 feet, 8 inches. Yet that slippage of rock happened 3 miles down, 40 miles away from here, and I felt it. Did I see it? No. Did I feel it? You can be sure I did. This is precisely what we find in today's gospel. Did we see the Lord himself? Has he presented his wounds to you? Very few have seen those. There are saints who have been privied. But you and I, that hasn't happened. At least it hasn't happened yet. Do I see it? No. Do I feel it? Yes. Today is the Sunday of Divine Mercy. Divine Mercy. Can we see it? I want a box of mercy. No. Can I feel it? Yes. And are there signs and effects around me that guarantee that that mercy is there? Could you imagine, after the resurrection, Jesus arriving in heaven and addressing the Father and saying, please don't send me back down there. They're miserable. I made friends and they betrayed me. I healed people and they shouted to have me crucified. Please don't send me back down there. That's not the case. After his resurrection, he comes back. What, for more? No, because the love transcended the incident of the crucifixion and goes into the divine mercy of God upon each one of us. Why is it that we look on the crucifix and we see the wounds? We see the hands, we see the feet, we see the wound in the side. Well, now it's after Easter. Wouldn't it be better? I mean, wouldn't it be better if we just covered that stuff up? I don't think so. It's a stark reminder of what humanity is capable of. I mean, you don't have to go back 2,000 years because it's happening today, and of all places, the Holy Land in Ukraine. And other places on a lesser scale. Those wounds remind us of God's mercy. We have gone through what the Lord has gone through if you've made it this far in life. You have been wounded, you have been betrayed, and if you haven't, congratulations. Those things leave wounds. And it seems that every time we get into those situations, we find ourselves more and more removed from the Father. How could the Father leave me in this situation? But you see, his Son endured that situation and is there, waiting to bring us back to the Father. Have I felt the mercy of God? Yes.
And in a way, I have seen it. In the way enemies treat each other when they make up and come to their senses. I have seen that mercy when those people who put themselves down realize that they are a divine being manufactured in the image of the Father. Yes, I have seen this mercy and I have felt it. The Father sent his Son to pray for each one of us, and we are blessed because you're here at 4:30 and at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And the Lord himself precisely talks about you right here. Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed.
I believe in one God. Together we place our needs before our Father.
That the church may continue to grow in charity and faith as she remains a sign of God's merciful love for all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may look favorably upon and provide the resources for the needs of individuals and communities. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have been separated from God by sin may experience forgiveness and healing through the sacrament of reconciliation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all of us gathered here may be guided by the Holy Spirit in our work to build up the kingdom of God on earth by our words and actions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may be welcomed into the kingdom of heaven and see the face of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This afternoon's Mass is offered for the repose of the souls of Anthony Ciafalo and Florence Miola. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers and intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for peace in the Holy Land and in Ukraine. We pray to the Lord. Father, hear these prayers, the ones that were said and the ones that are known only between you and we alone. Grant us the grace and the energy to bring them about. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Please join in singing number 291, We Walk by Faith, 291.
We walk by faith and not by sight. No precious words we hear from Christ who spoke as none has spoke, but we believe him. His hand inside, nor follow where he tries.
pray, my brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Amen. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblation of your people, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, we may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. So great is your love for humanity that you sent us your Son in order to show us who you are, a loving Father, always present to his people, and to show us what we could become, a people who are your best ambassadors in this world. For the privilege of being called your children in this world, we join with all the choirs of angels in heaven as together we sing.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper had ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of this body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world, and help us to grow in charity, together with Francis the Pope, David the Bishop, John our pastor, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in the hope of rising again. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your face. Finally, have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the ever-Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles and saints and all those who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from needless and useless anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Thank you. Offer us to each other silent.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep us in everlasting life.
Please join in singing number 208, There's a Wideness in God's Mercy, 208.
Kindness in God's justice, which is
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and in our hearts. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The prayer to our patron, Saint Michael. And one last salutation that I feel that the Lord himself would want to tell you. Blessed are you who have not seen and believe. Amen. This Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Please join in our closing song, number 233. Alleluia, sing to Jesus, 233.